Hello VSDC users, we've got exciting news. The new version of VSDC is finally here. And this time, it is special. Version 10.1 marks our 10th major release, and it is packed with powerful features, smart improvements, and creative tools designed to make your video editing smoother and more convenient. So let's dive in and see what's new. HDR support. One of the most anticipated updates is HDR support. If you're working with high-quality footage, you know how important it is to preserve details in both bright highlights and deep shadows. That is exactly what HDR is for. It brings out the full range of light and color in your videos. Starting with version 10.1, HDR files are now recognized and displayed correctly on the timeline right away. No extra steps. Just drop your HDR footage into the editor, and VSDC will apply the correct mode automatically. If you want more control, you can adjust the HDR settings manually in the object's properties. This feature is available in the Pro version and is ideal for anyone working with modern smartphones, action cameras, or professional gear. New settings for curve line. Another major upgrade has been made to the curve line tool. Now you can control the thickness of the line at every individual point along the curve. To try it out, create a curve line object and head over to the curve line extra settings. There you'll find controls for line cap style, rounding mode, and two types of contour blur, blurring and feathering. We've also improved the processing mode section to help fix any visual artifacts that may occur when drawing the curve. In the past, editing point properties meant navigating through the curve structure. Now it's much easier. Just hold Ctrl and click on any point. Its properties will instantly appear in the Properties window. The most powerful new option here is the Thickness setting. It lets you set different line widths at different points. For example, starting at 0%, going up to 200%, let's add a middle point and set its thickness to 50. See the result. Brush and pen parameters are now much easier to work with too. You just toggle them on and off. And of course, you can still animate the visible length of the line and choose from various fill types. Adding new points to curve line and free shape. And since we're talking about curves and shapes, there's more good news. We've completely reworked the algorithm for adding new points to curve line and free shape objects. Previously, inserting a new point could distort the existing path, which wasn't okay. Now, new points are automatically placed along the current trajectory, preserving the original shape. Presets for curve line and free shape. To help speed things up even more, we've added a new collection of templates for curve line and expanded the library for free shape. All 157 templates are available in the free version of the editor. Just select a shape, choose the From Gallery option, pick the template you like, and draw the area on the scene. If you want to keep the original aspect ratio of the template, just hold Shift while drawing the template frame. GPS telemetry. Moving on to another powerful feature, GPS telemetry support. If you're working with footage from an action camera or a smartphone that recorded location data, you can now visualize that data right in the project. When you load a video that includes telemetry, VSDC will offer to extract the data into a separate resource. Once it's on the timeline, the route will be displayed automatically. You can choose how it looks or select one of the built-in presets. And if your device recorded additional data like elevation or markers, or you've added them manually, those will appear too. This feature is part of the Pro version, and we're planning to expand telemetry capacities even further in upcoming updates. Let us know in the comments if you've used telemetry before, or if this is your first time hearing about it. New effects. Now let's talk about effects, because visuals and audio are always at the heart of great editing. First up is the new Duotone effect. This is a color correction tool that lets you recolor your footage using a custom gradient. You might have seen something similar in other editors, but in VSDC, Duotone is way more flexible. When you apply the effect, it starts with a black and white gradient by default, but you can easily change the color, adjust transparency, add a midpoint, and fine-tune its properties. You can even animate all three gradient stops independently, which means you can create smooth, shifting color transition throughout your video. And with 50 ready-made presets to choose from, some free, others in the Pro version, it's never been easier to get the look you want. Alongside Duotone, we've added channel remapping. It is a handy tool for controlling how audio channels are played back. For instance, you can take audio from the left channel and send it to the right, effectively turning stereo sound into mono. Just apply the effect to an audio layer and change the channel assignment in the properties. New templates and presets. But that is not all. This release includes over 600 new templates and presets. Yes, you heard that right, 600. There are lots of new premium collections available through our store. They include 20 animated backgrounds from the Kinetic Sparks collection. Three stylish title packs with 15 items each. And 9 packs of sketch style elements featuring over 150 creative assets. You'll also find 30 new transitions inside the brush stroke and soft crayon folders. And if you want it all, the exclusive bundle offer lets you unlock every premium template in one go. Now, let's highlight some of the new templates available in both the free and Pro versions. First up, perspective effect templates. Templates from the advanced folder allow you to create stunning in and out animations. For example, let's add a star shape to the scene and apply a perspective template to it. As you'll notice, the effect works, but the aspect ratio may get distorted. To fix that, remove the effect, then hold Shift and drag the template onto the object again. Holding Shift ensures that the template adapts to the aspect ratio of the target object. This new behavior can be very useful for many types of templates. Once the effect is applied correctly, you can shorten the duration and even add an out effect to complete the animation. A Feel free to combine different in and out templates for custom motion. Next up are shift effect templates used to create shake animations. These templates are sorted by intensity, so you can choose how strong the effect should be. Then the zoom templates come, which make it easy to animate zoom in and zoom out motion. They're perfect for slideshows when you want to add some dynamic movement to your photos. Moving on to distort effect templates. Just like with perspective, these include in and out animations to control how elements appear and disappear. You'll also find templates for each distort variation. We've also added new templates for the lens distort effect with various distortion strength and for lens flare, featuring different brightness levels, colors, and glare styles. Also, try new transition collections that were created from distort and perspective effects. You can find them only in the template window. Finally, we've expanded the selection of text animation templates. These include effects like recoloring, shift position, and glyph FX. They're designed to work as entrance and exit animation for text objects. Here's how it works. Create several text objects, select them, and then drag a template from the In folder onto the scene. After that, drag another template from the Out folder. The editor will automatically apply the entrance and exit animations to the selected texts, making it faster and easier than ever to animate text. In total, 18 templates are available for free users and 56 for pro users. Also note, most effect templates are now available directly in the Effects Presets property, so you can access them anytime without leaving the Properties window. Better performance and full support for modern formats. We've also added support for the HEIC codec used in iPhone 16, so videos from newer Apple devices can be edited smoothly in VSDC. On top of that, we've introduced hardware acceleration for AV1, VP9, and MJPEG decoders, significantly improving performance. Other improvements. And finally, there are a number of small but powerful improvements that make editing even more precise. In the Basic Effects window, you can now enter exact values for parameters and apply effects directly to the timeline. Subtitles can be converted to editable text with a single click. The Amplify effect now supports percent-based volume control for easier sound balancing. You can assign metadata keywords to your projects. And proportional resizing, when holding Shift, now works on side handles too, not just the corners. You can also mark your favorite template directly from the preview window, and pro users have the option to hide their license or company name from the interface. We've also fully localized the interface in Polish, expanding accessibility for our international community. And of course, behind the scenes, we've fixed bugs, including those reported on our social media and directly to our support team, to ensure a faster, more stable, and more enjoyable editing experience. Thank you for choosing VSDC, and we can't wait to hear what you think of VSDC 10.1. We truly hope this update inspires your creativity and helps bring your ideas to life.